What's up, my YouTube family? Sergeant Greybeard back with another Division 2 video. Today is Monday, May 10th, and as always, I hope this message finds you healthy and safe. Needless to say, last week we received a lot of information in regards to the future of the Division franchise that I don't think any of us really expected. So today I'd like to take some time and go over some of the questions that you've sent the channel over the weekend. Now, if you happen to be new here, first of all, welcome. Secondly, feel free to hit that subscribe button. We would love for you to be a part of our gaming family. And if you enjoyed this or found it helpful at all, take a quick second and hit that like button. It really, really helps us out. Finally, as most of you know, we have giveaways here, and our current one is for a PlayStation 5, and all you need to do to enter is either subscribe here or follow us on Twitter. Either way is fine. The winner will be announced on July 4th of this year, and as I've said in every previous video, please keep in mind that watching our content is not a requirement to win. Only watch the things here you may enjoy. That's why you have the option of entering via Twitter. Having said that, let's get into today's video. So the first thing I'd like to talk about today is the response that I've seen from the Division community in regards to all of this news, and it's really polarizing. I mean, you have people who are very, very excited, and you have other people thinking, you know what, it's probably not going to be what we're looking for. Some of you have reached out to the channel asking, what do I think about all this information? And to be honest with you, I am extremely excited about it. But at the same time, you know, I'm not getting my hopes up on something specific because really, we have no idea what we can expect. And the main reason I say that is keep in mind, just a few months ago, 12.1 apparently was going to be it for the game. And you know, then we find out there's going to be new content for the Division 2 at the end of the year. And now we find out all this other stuff is coming as well. I mean, on a personal note, I would love to see Survival come back. Like, I love that game mode, and to be honest with you, whatever they bring to the game next, I really think no matter what, it's great for the community, and I also think, in my opinion, it's only a matter of time before they talk about the third game. However, that, my friends, is a conversation we will save for a later date. So right now, what I'd like to talk about is the current timeline and when we may be able to expect some of the new content that the game has promised us. So based on the timeline that the game put out last week, you can see next we get Heartland, then we get the new content, then the mobile game, and so on and so forth. And many of you were wondering, you know, will this new content be tied to anything that has to do with the current seasons that we're having? And actually, when I say that, what I'm referencing is a lot of you were wondering, you know, are we going to need to go through all four seasons again before we see anything new? And the chances are that's not going to happen. Keep in mind, each season is about 3 months, so that puts us well into next year. Now, we all know the game has said we're not going to get anything new until late 2021 or early 2022. However, always remember that these things can run in conjunction, so the season should have no impact on when the actual new stuff is released. The next thing I'd like to talk about is the announcement of the mobile aspect of this game, and many of you reached out to the channel saying you're worried about it, how's it going to affect the game that we play on, whether it's PC, console, whatever it is, and to be honest with you guys, remember, it's a completely and totally separate thing than what we're actually playing right now. I mean, a perfect example I can give you is look at the Assassin's Creed franchise. You know, you play that game on console or PC, it's one way, and then when you play it on the actual app itself, you have Assassin's Creed, you know, Identity, you have Assassin's Creed Rebellion, totally separate things, and one game does not affect the other. I think the main concern that a lot of people have is, you know, is this going to pull away from the main game itself? You know, a lot of us have been waiting for new content for a while, is this going to mess things up? And the answer is no, it's not. Different departments, different things, so again, one should not affect the other in any way whatsoever. Now moving on to what people actually want to see from these new game modes, and we're going to get a lot of rumors, we're going to get a lot of, you know, there's going to be a lot of stuff flying around until we actually get tangible information. Now my hope is that we'll actually get something next month at E3 when they announce hopefully an idea of what we can expect on June 12th. And based on the feedback that I've received here at the channel and that I've also seen online, people are just looking for like a greatest hit. You know, they want the best aspects of the first game and the second game just mashed together and really bring, hopefully, everyone a lot of things they're looking for. And with that being said, my friends, do me a favor, let me know what you would like to see introduced back into this game, either back into this game or something new. As most of you know by now, the conversations we have are one of my favorite aspects about the channel. So again, let me know your thoughts down below. Finally, I'd like to take a moment and talk about the new series I'm going to be starting at the end of this week called Diplomats of the Division. And to be honest with you, I brought this up last week. Your response was incredible. I thank you guys so much for being so supportive of this channel. Now, as I mentioned previously, this is something I'm going to try to do every week, and if not every week, every other week, but again, it's going to be a place where we celebrate the game, its players, you know, cosplay, virtual photography, content creators, pretty much the entire community and what makes this thing so amazing. With that being said, I've received so many messages at the channel about people who you'd love to hear from and talk about their experience with the game, and I'm making a list of all of the people that, you know, you've brought up. It's something that I'm going to continue to do for a while, so again, please feel free to let me know people who you'd like to hear from down below. This series is actually something I've been thinking about for a while, and I thought, you know, I'd put it out there, see what kind of response I got, and again, my friends, it was amazing. I cannot thank you enough. Now, I'm kind of putting this thing together pretty quick, so hopefully you will enjoy it, but again, it's just the first one. We'll see what happens. And once again, my friends, to be totally clear and transparent, which you know I always want to do with this channel, this series is about celebrating the game and the people who are around it, which in my opinion are the best part of this game. So again, it's not a place where we're complaining about this or that or whatever aspects of the game. It's about celebrating the actual people who play it. Now, later today via Twitter, I will be announcing who the first four guests are. Right now, my goal is this, or the plan is this. It's going to be about a 30 to 45 minute show where each person gets anywhere from 8 to 10 minutes, talk about stuff. And again, it's a template. We'll see what you guys think and we'll go from there. I'll also be making a post with this information via YouTube for people who do not have Twitter. And once again, my friends, please feel free to leave any questions that you'd like to ask these people in the comment section down below of those posts. However, be respectful, otherwise you're blocked. I do not care. On that note, my friends, I'm going to start to wrap this up. As always, once again, I want to thank you all for your continued support. I love you all. I sincerely appreciate, you know, just everything you guys have brought to this community means the world to me, and I cannot wait to share whatever the future holds. It's going to be good, in my opinion, my friends. At this point, my friends, I'm going to let the rest of the video play out. However, as I mentioned at the beginning of this thing, if you happen to be new here, feel free to hit that subscribe button. If you enjoyed this, you could hit that like button as well. But most importantly, take care of yourselves, be kind to each other, and we will talk to you soon. Thanks again, everyone.
According to the schematics Isaac pulled upstairs, we can lock that tunnel door from their control center. That should keep them from being able to transport those mortars loaded with DC-62. That should keep them from getting more of those mortars.
You think closing the tunnel is smart? Fuck you! You can lock yourself in with us. I'll make sure you die out here.
Don't spy! Thank you!
To head back up. The team from the campus is taking position inside the memorial. If you hadn't stopped them, I know they would have used those weapons on us, and we would have ended up like Castle. I can't tell you how relieved I am to have you on our side. Thank you. Today, we dealt a great blow to the True Sun's infrastructure.